Hi guys, it's Mia here. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today is a big day for me. So you guys already know I'm obsessed with horses. And I grew up watching the movie Spirit Stallion of the Cimarron. And today, June 4th, they released a movie called Spirit Untamed. It's basically like the sequel to the original movie, and I have to see it. Within this video too, not only am I gonna watch the movie, but I'm going to explain like the whole backstory on why I love horses, how Spirit like literally raised me as a kid. So you guys will like get to know me a little more. So if you're excited, don't forget to like and subscribe. Let's get started. So before I see Spirit Untamed, I want to talk about the original because I'm not even exaggerating when I say this movie raised me. Spirit Stallion of the Cimarron came out in 2002 and I was born in 2001 and I saw it in theaters with my parents. I just don't remember because I was around 1 or 2 years old. But that movie is the reason I am still obsessed with horses to this day because I do remember when I was around like 4 or 5, I went to a DVD store and I remember seeing the Spirit DVD and I was begging my mom to get it for me and she did. And I would watch it over and over and over again. I broke the DVD because of how many times I watched it. As a kid too, I even had like merch. Like I had little horse figurines of Spirit and Rain. I had so much merchandise, not as much though, but as I got older, I realized there's actually a lot of merch and the little child in me wants to like collect all of it. It's all on eBay, but it's way too expensive. But I grew up with that horse. I'm going to show you guys clips of my room and childhood pictures of mine because Spirit was my life. When I was little in school, I would draw pictures of him. I have a picture of him hanging in my room to this day. I have a shelf in my room of all my Spirit toys. Like, I am the extreme Spirit fan. Above my Spirit shelf is another horse shelf. This picture is me on my birthday around 7 or 8 years old. That's Anthony on my lap, and my parents got me that horse. Her name was Coca-Cola. And then on this picture, another toy horse I got, I was around maybe 10 years old, and this was on Christmas, and I named her Bella. And to this day, I still have Bella because she has a lot of sentimental value. And she's a for real friend's horse, this huge animatronic in my room. I love her so much, and because of Spirit, I literally took her halter off just so I could be like, you're free now. I also still have Coca-Cola in my room. She's basically my dog's bed because they love laying on her. I remember it was like my 7th birthday and I blew out my candles after saying I wish I had a horse, and my parents drug her out of a room they were hiding her in, and I was so happy. So she has a lot of sentimental value as well as Bella. In elementary, I forced all my friends to watch the movie, and I remember we would literally run around the recess yard galloping and reenact the movie. When I was little, I rode ponies at like zoos and birthday parties, but I never actually had horseback riding lessons until my freshman year of high school. I was 15 and for years I begged my parents after watching Spirit for horseback riding lessons so I could be around horses, my true passion. But we never knew of a stables near my house, so it took so long for me to find an actual stables to take my lessons at. But then that summer of my freshman year, I remember Googling stables near me, and I found a stables literally 10 minutes away from my house. If I walked there, it would probably take an hour, but it's so close. Like, where was this barn all my life? Because it's so close, and I've been going there ever since. Now that place is like my second home, and you guys know how in my birthday video of my dog, I'm really superstitious. It might sound crazy, but I believe like coincidences are more than coincidences. Like, I think they're signs. I don't know, I think they're good luck. And you know how Spirit's mate, Rain, she's a paint mare? The very first horse I rode when I found the stables was a mare named Tess, and she was also a paint mare. I'll insert a picture right here. She was really beautiful. Another coincidence that I think is so crazy, I am bad at literally every single sport. I am not athletic at all, but for some reason, the one sport I'm good at is horseback riding. Like, that's a sign. It's meant to be. I'm not even exaggerating. That movie is my life. It's the reason why I am the way I am today. Like, I love horses. Ever since I watched that movie, I've been involved with horses. Like, they're my life. If you haven't seen Spirit, you definitely should, because this isn't a movie that's just for like horse girls. Like, anyone can enjoy it. I made my friends in my YouTube videos that you see, I made them watch it, and even they loved it. So you guys definitely should see it. The meaning of the movie is so beautiful. It's just about this horse trying to win his freedom, and I feel like anyone can relate. That movie came out a while ago, Spirit Stallion of the Cimarron, but you guys may have heard of Spirit Riding Free. It's a kid's show. Now, they turned that gorgeous original Spirit Stallion of the Cimarron into a kid's show, and a lot of people were upset about that, and so was I. Spirit Untamed is basically a retelling of the first episode of Spirit Riding Free, and not many of the fans enjoy that. And I'm gonna explain like my opinion on it. When I was growing up, I was bullied for liking horses, but I didn't realize until I was older and there was social media that there's so many people like me who also love spirit. And that just makes me so happy because it's like I'm not alone. Now I see how many people just like me enjoy the movie. So a lot of us did grow up with Spirit's Down with the Summer On, but when we saw Spirit Riding Free, we got real upset because they just took this whole movie and turned it into a kid's show. So a lot of us who grew with Spirit's Down with the Summer On did not take too kindly to them turning it into a kid's show. So for me, when Spirit Riding Free came out, I was like, what in the Spirit Walmart knockoff? But before I watched it, I didn't judge it too harshly because I wanted to give it a chance. And when I watched it, I actually didn't hate it. And I'm a child at heart, so of course I'm enjoying this kid show about horses. It actually kind of motivated me so much that when I watched the first episode, I literally grabbed my phone and I searched stables near me because this show looked so fun. Like all these girls just having the time of their life and going on adventures on their horses. I was like, I want that. So then I searched stables near me and I found the stables that I go to this day that I made a video on. Another superstitious coincidence, the show was meant for me because if it weren't for that show, I wouldn't have found the stables. Before I made this video, I watched a whole bunch of videos about people's opinions and I definitely agree, and this is my opinion on Spirit Riding Free. A 12-year-old girl who is riding a Wad Mustang and she's never even sat on a horse before is so far-fetched to me, especially with no tack and when she's literally only met this horse once. I feel like the show was actually meant to be about Spirit himself, like the actual horse from the original movie, but we hated it so much that they were just like, oh no, it's Spirit and Rain's son, which is why they probably swapped out the dorsal stripe for his white blaze. But you would think if it's Spirit and Rain's son, this horse wouldn't be so easily tameable like he was in the first episode. And it's also unrealistic because Little Creek from the original movie, he took a while to bond with Spirit. Spirit didn't take too kindly to him at first, but then after a while, you know, they became close. But Lucky literally fed him an apple and they were like besties. That's also unrealistic. I think the reason that this show is so unrealistic is because it's a kids show. They don't care. Kids will watch anything. Spirit's Down of the Summer On is animated and marketed towards kids, but it covered like deep meanings such as being free, animal abuse, or Native Americans and white settlers interacting with each other. The one thing about Spirit's Down of the Summer On that's unique is it's not like a stereotypical horse girl movie where a girl meets a horse and they bond and stuff. It was just about Spirit, and all of the characters were horses except the two humans, the Colonel and Little Creek. There was no female human main characters. It was a guy. That's really important because boys usually get made fun of for riding horses because now it's like mainly girls who ride them. The horse girl shows in movies are just so overused, and like the girl power that's forced is so annoying. Spirit's Down of the Summer On is different because it didn't have a gender bias and anyone could watch it, any gender, any age. But with Spirit Riding Free, you can definitely tell that it's a movie aimed for little girls. They took out everything that was unique about Spirit's Down of the Summer On and turned it into this children's girl show. They literally took everything unique about Spirit's Down of the Summer On and turned it into the opposite of what it was. They even made the logo of Spirit Riding Free more girlish and the toy packaging more girlish. When compared to Spirit, it was red and bold, while Spirit Riding Free, even though it's my favorite color teal, the packaging is a little more girly. The thing that stood out about Spirit's Down of the Summer On was there was no dialogue. The horses spoke to each other and you could understand it even when there was no dialogue. They didn't need to talk for you to understand the movie, and it's in the point of view of the horse, which is so interesting and unique. I'm sure that with Spirit Riding Free, they could have kept that because even little kids could understand Spirit's Down of the Summer On. But with Spirit Riding Free, it's not really about the horses anymore. It's about this girl named Lucky, and it's not even Spirit Riding Free because he isn't technically free. He's basically Lucky's taxi service when she wants to go on adventures or school. In the original movie, Spirit was nobody's horse, not even Little Creek. The show made it completely opposite. Another thing that's really opposite is the whole main scene of Spirit Riding Free is Spirit racing the train and Lucky goes out to reach him. But in the original movie, Spirit literally almost got crushed and blown up by a train. I think that's so funny because it's like he went from running from a train to now he's chasing one. Another thing that's completely opposite is the animation choice. I don't understand how Spirit's Down of the Summer On was 2D animated and was like two decades ago, and the animation is better than the 3D animation in the kids show. I know there's budgets and stuff, but it sucks that they should have just left the original movie alone and not even make a show, because the original is such a masterpiece. They shouldn't have touched it. They definitely didn't put the same amount of effort at that they put in the movie than in the show. The movie took a few years to make, actually, and it was based off a real horse named Donner. They definitely didn't put the same time and effort as they did for the original movie. Every time I watch Spear of the Stallion of the Cimarron, I cry. I cry every time because it's so powerful, and like you don't even get sick of it because you just go through the emotions of the movie and the horse, and the music makes it even more harder to not cry. But since Spirit Riding Free is a kid show, they made it more adventurous and effortless rather than emotional and moving. Unlike the videos where people gave their opinion on Spirit Riding Free and it was mainly negative, I actually have many positives on why I like the show, even though I just ranted about what I hate about it. I'm pretty open-minded, so when I watched it, I put my mindset as like a child watching this show. So I definitely could see why little girls would love this. I think I would love it too if I was a kid and I grew up with this show. First off, when I was little, I was so obsessed with Spirit that I remember for every single birthday I've had, I wished for Spirit and Rain as if they would come to life through the screen and I'd own them as two horses. So what I love about Spirit Riding Free is Lucky is literally living the life I wanted to live as a little girl. I wanted Spirit and I wanted the life of galloping and the wind in my hair and just feeling so free on this powerful wild horse. And I love how she rides him with no tack and he gets to choose whether he wants to be with her for a day or run off to his herd. I remember when I was little, I asked my dad for a horse and he would always be like, where are you gonna put it? And I would be like, in the garage, or I'll just like tie him to the outside of the house. So I just love how Spirit literally walks up to the front lawn of Lucky's house and waits for her to come out. That animated child is literally living the dream I had as a child. I just love how the main character is Hispanic just like me and she loves horses just like me. Another superstitious coincidence. I think it's so amazing how a diverse main character is relating herself with horses, just like Little Creek from Spirit Stallion of the Cimarron, because I feel like it's predominantly white females involved with horses, so I think it's so relatable to see a Hispanic main character. It low-key makes me really proud to be Puerto Rican. Finally, I love this show because of the toys too. When Spirit Stallion of the Cimarron came out, I was around like one or two, and I don't even remember if there were toys on the shelves. I got my toys of Spirit from eBay. I never actually went to a store and saw him on the shelves, but with Spirit Riding Free, I actually get to experience what it's like going to the toy aisle and seeing this horse that I grew up with around me and on the shelves where kids can enjoy him just like I did. It like settles a part of my childhood that I wish I experienced. I also like how there's a short episode where they explain Spirit Jr. from the Riding Free show. They explain his backstory and his parents, which are Spirit and Rain, and they show them, which I think is so cool. I like that they called it back to the original characters. I'm really glad they did that. I thought they were just gonna ignore them like they never existed because they never showed Spirit and Rain and is heard in the show. In conclusion, I'm actually not mad anymore about Spirit Riding Free because of this. They didn't ruin Spirit, as everyone says, because the horse in Spirit Riding Free isn't even Spirit. It's his son. So in my mindset when I watch the show, I'm just like, you know what? Yeah, go ruin his son. Just don't touch the original Spirit. If they did actually take the horse from the original movie and made a show about him specifically, then I would be furious. But it's not, so I can just push it aside and actually sit back and enjoy the show. Even though the show is the complete opposite of the movie and Spirit isn't even free, like the whole message of the movie, Spirit's son doesn't actually have to be exactly like him. It's kind of cool if you really think about it how they did the exact opposite, because it's a whole fresh new story rather than repeating in his father's footsteps or hoofsteps. My thing is, I do completely understand though why people are mad that DreamWorks turned this a miraculous movie into some low budget cash grab. They could have just used any random horse, but they used Spirit's name because they knew we would all watch it because it's Spirit, the icon. I just can't believe how the same company that made this movie made this show. But in the end, as long as this show makes some child happy and makes some child decide that they want to have a future with horses, I'm so happy with that. Spirit Stallion of the Cimarron taught me how amazing horses are. So if that show can do that with a kid, that's everything. But anyway, the moral of the story with the show is, just because you can do something doesn't mean you should. Should have left the original movie alone, but now it's too late, so we just gotta enjoy the show. Now let's talk about the movie we're gonna see. This won't be long. I'm just gonna tell you guys how I feel about it based on the trailers I've seen. I'm no movie review channel, and I'm not like a literature teacher who looks at every symbolic thing in a movie. So part like 1,000 of me saying this movie's meant for me and I'm superstitious. Here's another one. So the trailer came out in March, the same month that my dog was born, Anthony, who passed away. The movie poster for the movie was released on the same week of Easter, my favorite holiday, and the same week I went back to the stables after a while because the COVID cases were getting high. That same week too, I started therapy. So I feel like it was just a gift from the universe for, you know, like taking care of my mental health and having all those crazy coincidence correlations. And I just, so happy, so glad it's all attached to each other. And the biggest coincidence, today, June 4th, the day the movie comes out, it's my best friend Lauren Paroli's birthday. She's in basically almost all my videos. She should have skipped her birthday plans to go to the beach. Instead, she should have went to the horse movie with us, but I see how it is. Just kidding. And not only that, another coincidence is today, Conjuring 3 comes out. I love the Conjuring movies. I love horror movies, and they're my all-time favorite horror films. So all of these coincidences, they're meant for me. I know they are. I just thought of another coincidence that I forgot. I love the horror movie Hannibal Lecter, and Clarice, she is the actor who voices Aunt Cora in Spirit Untamed. It's literally just all perfect timing. They low-key should have released this movie though in 2022, so it could have been the exact 20th anniversary of the movie, and they should have released it in May, just like the original Spirit Style of the Summer on movie. That would have been really cool. But yeah, I'm super excited to watch this movie, and I'm gonna watch with my friends, so I cannot wait. So now that you have some background on me and why I love horses and why I'm seeing this movie, I cannot wait. My friends and I are gonna see it together, and we're literally gonna be like the only 19-year-olds that this movie is literally for 6-year-olds. So I will see you guys in the theater. I forgot to show you guys my outfit, so I styled my bangs, and then this sweatshirt I got from one of my favorite YouTubers merch store. I'm gonna link it down below, but it has Rain from Spirit, the original movie, and her horse sharing an apple, and it says eat more plants because the YouTuber, she's an equine activist, so all her merch relates to that. And I got this immediately because it was related to Spirit the horse. And then I have on my jeans and my Vans, and on my fanny pack I have a Spirit keychain. I'll also link this down below. Later, I want to go to the barn and take a really cute picture with one of the horses in my Riley Link 14 merch, because I heard that every time you post yourself in your merch, she reposts on her Instagram. So I hope she reposts my picture, and I hope she's watching this. You guys should definitely subscribe to her. I'll put her down below. And Riley, if you're watching this, I love you so much. You're a big inspiration of mine.
Before I pick up Leah, I'm gonna put these Spirit the Horse stickers on my car. I'll link them down below, but they're so cute. I'm gonna put them right here. How satisfying. Look how cute it looks. This place is literally a ghost town. I haven't been in a theater in like over a year. And it's crazy how the time we actually go to the theaters, it's this movie. It's meant to be.
Yeah, we're doing kids. Look at the price difference.
Now we're gonna watch my movie, and look, we got our tickets.
We paid child's price.
We're literally 19-year-old got to child tickets to see a child movie. Bro, look what they gave us, and we're in theater 7, lucky number 7. Oh my god, what is this?
I'm ready.
Okay, so we're back from seeing the movie, and it was like really, really, really good. But they literally promoted Taylor Swift, and she wasn't.
And they never played the song.
We were waiting for Wildest Dreams, and they never played it.
I was like, wow. There were so many times we thought it was her too.
I know, there were so many good songs that never even ended up playing.
Hi guys, I'm back from seeing Spirit Untamed, and I loved the movie. This isn't gonna be like a movie review because I'm too lazy to get into details and get into all of that, but overall it was so good. There were so many Easter eggs, like frame by frame, that referenced back to the original Spirit the Horse movie, so that made me so happy. The only thing I didn't like that they didn't reference was Spirit and Rain. Like, I wish that when Lucky saw the herd, like maybe Spirit and Rain showed up. I would have loved to see them in 3D. Just like the show, the movie was really childish. It wasn't as good as the original, but honestly I was still happy because there were so many kids in the theater that movie probably impacted that they're maybe going to take horseback riding lessons, so I do not care. What I really like about the movie is that they completely went in the opposite direction of Spirit Riding Free's ending. Spoiler alert, but Lucky and Spirit actually part ways. You know how in the end of the show, she frees Spirit and then he comes back to her because he loved her and they have a bond or whatever? In the movie, she actually says goodbye to him, and that shocked me so much because I thought that it was going to be just like the show where he comes back, they ride, and then he bounces back to his herd and back and forth. But she actually said goodbye to him, like forever, just like Little Creek and Spirit did in the original movie. I really like that because that is more realistic. A wild horse is going to obviously prefer his herd than a girl he met in a, like 2 days or whatever. But that made me so happy, but I was so shocked. And at the end of the movie, Abigail, I think it was Abigail who said to Lucky, she was like, oh, we're going to find you a new horse now. So that's really how it ended. She's going to probably be a horse girl now and she's going to have her own horse, but it's not going to be Spirit. Another thing that was different is Aunt Cora. In the show, she completely left Lucky to form her own life. But in the movie, she actually stays in Maradero to live the rustic life. And that's so not like her in the show. But that was cool that they added that. Jim Prescott, Lucky's dad, is completely different from the show. Like, not only is his mustache gone, but like the whole backstory of him and his wife and why he doesn't want Lucky to ride because the wife died. He was a really interesting character. And that's another thing I just remembered. Leah and I were in the theaters and the opening scene is the mom, Milagro, riding her horse and doing the stunts on her horse. And she does a trick and she dies. Bro, we were literally 2 minutes in maybe in the movie and she just dies. Like, it was really shocking for a kids movie how quick that escalated. It wasn't funny that she died, but it was just so funny how quick that happened. Like, me and Leah literally looked at each other like it was so crazy how that was the opening scene of the mom dying. It set the story in line, but wow, they really killed her quickly. But that's why Jim doesn't want Lucky to ride, because he saw that his wife, her mother, died on this horse, that he doesn't want the same thing to happen to Lucky, which I thought was really, really interesting. I love that. It was much, much better than the first episode of Spirit Riding Free. The thing I like that was different too is in the show, because it's probably cheaper, like there's a lower budget, all of the horses basically look the same in Spirit's herd, but in the movie, they were all these diverse, beautiful colors. Like, he had a really gorgeous herd. It was even better than the first movie because most of the horses were, I think, like brown, gray, white, beige, but they had all these different types of patterns and stuff. And I like how the herd was also captured, not just Spirit like the original movie. So that was really cool and opposite. Another thing I like was Prue and Abigail's outfits. They were really, really cute. The only thing I didn't like about Lucky is in the show, her color's like red, and I think that's so cool because it's mainly like the main character is like wears a pink outfit or teal in kid shows or whatever. But she was like red and it was bold and it really went well with her. But in the movie, she wears pink, but whatever. Prue and Abigail's outfits were really cute though, and so were their horses' tack. Like, they did an amazing job, and their tack was more realistic than the show. But they gave a bit to both of the horses, and I do not support bits. You could watch Riley's videos for more info. But that was still cool how their tack was much more better than the show. One more thing that I liked was the music. Becky G's song, Isabel Merced, the voice actress of Lucky, had a few songs too that were really good. The music obviously does not match up to the first movie. That can never be beat. But they really did scam us because Taylor Swift's song was not in the movie. And my friend Leah that I watched it with, she's obsessed with Taylor Swift. And that's the main reason she came with me to hear her new song, Wildest Dreams, like the new version. And they did not play it. We didn't stay to the credits. Maybe they did it at the very, very end. But at the very first credits, it was Becky G's song, which was really good though. I'm glad it was still in there. But they did not play Taylor Swift's song. It was kind of funny because we kept waiting. Like, there were like really dramatic, beautiful scenes where like Spirit's galloping with Lucky. And we were like, oh my God, that's a time where they should play the song. But they never played the song and it was so funny. But we were so mad. They did really market a lot out of this movie though. They got a Snapchat filter. They've got an Instagram filter. They had Kim Kardashian advertise it. They put Kim Kardashian's horse as a toy from the Spirit collection. They made all of these professional riders toys. Like, they really advertised this movie. We saw billboards. We saw like movie posters on buildings. Like, they really
Spirit was everywhere, and I love that because it just did something to my childhood. Overall, I really love the movie. It's not as good as the first one, it never will be. We can't even compare it because they're in the same universe, but at least it wasn't basically like a sequel. Like, they were doing it about Spirit's son. But it just made me really happy that this is just gonna be another horse girl movie that I had fun. I felt like a child, and it was a great first movie to come back to in the theaters. I'm always gonna keep the tickets they gave me as a memory because I got to see like the icon in theaters on the big screen. And when we saw the movie, they give us these. They're so cute. They're sticker patches. They're basically like blind bags. You can get a bunch of them. These are the different versions of the badges you can get. I'm gonna open them up for you guys. Leah gave me hers, so I have two. I'm about to see the movie like 10 more times just so I can collect all of them. But this is the first one. It says Untamed. It's so cute. And it's, you don't have to actually sew it on your clothes. It's actually a sticker too, but I don't wanna like use the sticker. I wanna keep it. So that's the first one. There's five you can collect. This one's really cute. It's Spirit and Lucky. I got two of them. I thought that was so cute. I've never seen that. They handed it to us like when you see a movie in 3D, like the glasses. That was really cute. I did not expect that. So yeah, I think you should see Spirit Untamed. It was a really cute movie. I think anyone could enjoy it. I have a few videos planned because you guys know I'm a child at heart, of me unboxing some of the Spirit Untamed toys. They're so cute. I cannot wait to show them. So if you're looking forward to that, don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and leave comments everywhere. Have a blessed day.